The thing that I see mostly when I think about racism in America is the violence that it's causing. I've been beaten by police. I've been cuffed as a 15-year-old, beaten over my head. We have to understand the history behind this, and it's all structural racism.
This is across the United States. That's a disproportionate number of increase of girls of color in the juvenile justice system. And the concern for that is that that can be a pipeline into the criminal justice system. This is a public health crisis, and we have to call it that.
You simply cannot escape the grip of racism in the United States. I work with students who have not had access to the internet and have been completely closed out of the educational system during the pandemic.
And unfortunately, many Black and Hispanic people have no access to healthcare. The pandemic has further compounded the issue of racism. What resources have been given to organizations to provide a service to the folks who are impacted the most by the pandemic?
Kids growing up, and this is what their reality looks like. So they're only becoming a mirror reflection of what they see. This is on the policy level. We need to change that. Step in and ultimately be the change that you want to see.
We see this happening everywhere. We can't allow this to keep happening. We need to work on this now, and we need to get together and stop it now.
For 90 years, the YWCA has been on a mission to eliminate racism and empower women. The Center for Racial Equity is going to be a space where we bring people together to build an anti-racist movement.
We all know we have a problem, but it's not an African-American problem. It's not a white problem. It's not a Latinx problem. It's our problem. What are you going to do about it? And that's what the Y says. We're going to create a center to have these conversations positively.
I grew up in an age where people said, don't talk about religion and politics. But in reality, we may well be where we are right now because we didn't have these conversations in the past. When we look at some of the rises in hate crimes right now, the work that the Y is doing is critical to stemming those hate crimes and reversing that trend.
We need to call on more community leaders, political leaders, street leaders to come to the forefront and be able to speak out from their lived experiences. So it's amazing to see that the Westchester Center of Racial Equity is spearheading this movement or creating this space for open, intimate, raw, and uncomfortable dialogue.
We can't have too many organizations which are out there advocating for human rights and advocating for basic decency. And I think that the Y is exactly the type of organization that should be heading up this critical issue when we need it the most. It is a mecca for so many people of so many different backgrounds, so many different religious beliefs. And I think that to have all of that under one roof is just invaluable.